Hello friends, welcome to Target SSB. Today I'll be delivering a presentation on line of actual control. Line of actual control is a demarcation boundary that is used to separate India and China from each other. India shares a boundary of 3488 km with its neighboring country China, and this line of actual control basically separates both the countries from their territories. The inception of this term line of actual control was originated back in the year 1962 by Chinese Premier Zhou Enlai, in which he used this term in his letter written to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. And the line of actual control in narrow sense is used to separate, is a boundary that basically separates Jammu and Kashmir region from China and India. If we see about the 62 war, then 62 war had taken place in both the theaters. It has taken place in Northeastern Theater and Northwestern Theater, because China claims that this region of Arunachal Pradesh belongs to China as Northeast Frontier Agency, and this region of Jammu Kashmir is its Northwest Frontier Agency. And all the major battle and war had been taken place in the 62 war in this area. After that, war came to an end with the defeat of India, and this line of actual control till that time was used as an informal boundary between India and China for ceasefire. After that, there was a treaty signed between India and China in the year 1993, in which line of actual control was recognized as a boundary separating both the countries. So this boundary, this line actually originates from this region. This region is Askai Chin. Askai Chin is basically a region that fall under the Pakistan occupied Kashmir after 47. And then in the after 62 war, the Pakistan gave this particular region to China. This is often referred to as China-occupied Kashmir. And this line of actual control, it originates from this Aksai Chin, and it then covers the state of Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. These five states are covered in this line of actual control. Although we share a border of 3488 km with China, but this line of actual control is a boundary of total 4057 kilometers. Recently, in the year 2013, there was a standoff between India and China in northeastern state of Arunachal Pradesh. And then it was resolved by bilateral ties between both the countries, in which India gave a proposal to China to destroy its military construction taken place near Arunachal Pradesh, because they were perceiving it as a danger. Recently, there was a Dokalam issue. Dokalam is basically a tri-junction that lies between Bhutan, Sikkim and China. This conflict has taken place here in the year June 2017, and it took place for over 84 days and was finally resolved by bilateral talks between both the countries. NSA Ajit Doval has represented India in Beijing regarding the Doklam issue, and it was resolved. Recently, there was a news by Indian press that the construction at Doklam by China had again started. So they were looking it as a fair, because they think it was a construction regarding military structures. But then there was a General Bipin Rawat gave a bayan that these constructions that are taking place in the Doklam region are just temporary. India had not to fear from those temporary construction by China, and if any activities have been taken place there, then Indian army is ready for tackling those activities. So this is how the line of actual control gets its inception in year 62. And it was recognized as the line of demarcation line between India and China to separate its territory from each other. Also earlier we have also seen that McMahon line was also used. McMahon line is basically used to refer the demarcation line that separates Indian territory of northeast with China. So after the inception of line of actual control, line of actual control also covers this McMahon line, and this entire line originating from Jammu Kashmir, covering Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Bhutan, and then to Arunachal Pradesh is line of actual control. In my opinion, as we all know that India and China both are emerging and highly developed countries of South Asia. So this conflict between India and China should be resolved by having bilateral talks and diplomatic judgments, because war is not the only solution, because both the country are highly powered in warheads, and war is futile and always lead to destruction between both the countries. Bilateral ties is the only solution that both the countries should follow, because as we all know, China is a country which is having its boundaries with about 14 countries, and it is having conflict with 18 countries. So this fact proves that China is of some belligerent nature, and India should be vigilant of Chinese activities and should adopt the way of bilateral talks to resolve this matter, because we should be vigilant for China, because we have seen the events of 62 war when PM Jawaharlal Nehru had given the nara Hindi Chini Bhai Bhai, and after a month the war had started. So we should act vigilantly to the Chinese activity that would take place along this line of actual control. Though line of actual control is recognized as a line in which no activity should be taken place by both the countries. So this is all about line of actual control. Please like and subscribe the channel. Thank you.